Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is Marrakesh, Morocco, where civil riots are looming. Your targets are private banker Klaus Strandberg and army general Reza Zedan, two of the conspirators in a sinister plot to overthrow Morocco's fragile government. Strandberg, a former bank CEO who stole billions of dollars worth of savings from the Moroccan people, was facing trial for investment fraud. But early this morning, a band of heavily armed mercenaries freed Strandberg from his prison transport, resulting in the death of several police officers. Strandberg now takes refuge at his native Swedish consulate, in front of which crowds of angry protesters have gathered, demanding his handover to Moroccan authorities. We believe General Zedan orchestrated Strandberg's escape to infuriate the public and spark nationwide riots, allowing Zedan to impose martial law. Operating out of a field HQ at a nearby abandoned school, he will no doubt use the riots to depict the Rabat government as weak and inept, and persuade the general staff to support a fully-fledged military coup in the name of national security. Our client, building contractor Hamilton Lowe, who stands to lose a fortune in government contracts, has hired us to prevent the coup d'etat. To do so, you need to paralyze Zedan's rebel forces and prevent the riots from escalating further, hence the double contract. This is quite the political powder keg, 47, so be careful. The fate of a nation is at stake. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zedan won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Gonna get ripped apart.
Yeah, it's not good.
closer. Our colorful lamps are the best in Morocco. Come closer. Come closer. Our colorful lamps are the best in Morocco.
It may take a while. Come back in 10 minutes. Salam, what would you like? Pick a beautiful lamp?
Hello, sir.
You seen Crystal Dawn is suddenly popping up?
Good timing, too. But I don't see what Muzabuni or Harak would do here. We're not exactly oppressed.
I like Harak. Don't know about Muzabuni. I don't like the military. They stand for too much order for my taste. But Harak has ideas, you know, or an ideology that I can sympathize with.
What do you mean?
Well, he rejects the failed political dogmas of today. Democracy doesn't work.
Okay,
thanks, economic bubbles burst from like a leap year.
So you don't believe in democracy?
Oh, no, I do. I believe.
The hell are Crystal Dawn doing here?
What are you talking about? Crystal Dawn aren't here. That's an Eastern African problem.
What? Haven't you seen the leaflet flying around? That's the wall.
Oh, welcome, welcome. Take a look around and let me know if you see anything you like. How long have you been in here?
Look, sir. I have a tie for you. I've got all kinds of things.
Okay.
Can you believe my luck? I'm at the lobby checking out, and I hear this big shot producer from GNN on the phone with an agency desperate to get a cameraman for an interview with Claus Hugo Strandberg. Strandberg, the banker. Do you ever watch the news? Anyway, I tap him on the back, show him my press pass, and the guy is so relieved that he just pays me a month's salary up front. Of course I'm not gonna do it. There's no way I'm getting near that place. Besides, I've got all this nice free money, and the dunce doesn't even know my real name. Would you believe I said my name was Finley?
As in space.
Right. So I'm at the shisha place down near the bazaar. Whenever you can sneak out, come and join me, okay? Smoke is on me.
Hi.
He's got the fastest car in the whole world.
Good to see you,
I
sir.
I don't even know how to drive.
I know, Audrey. I'll do it tonight.
So what? Think they're gonna storm the place?
Oh, we're not barbarians. We've done it in just way.
Just.
Snail soup! Snail soup! Soft and warm and well cooked.
Snail meat! Snail meat! No bones! Wanna try some snail meat?
What should we do? If Crystal Dawn get involved, should we take action?
No, we can't. They will only bring more instability.
But we have been.
Take a deep breath. I guess that you're not ready.
The printing crew spreads fake propaganda in the name of Crystal Dawn, the Pan-African Liberation Movement. This encourages Moroccan citizens to rise up and take justice into their own hands, which of course is exactly what Zaidan is counting on. Very clever. Now, according to the printing schedule, the crew is out hanging posters, and they are likely to wear masks.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't let you through.
Thank you.
welcome, stranger. You want a fine hand-woven carpet from the Atlas Mountains, or maybe a rare antique one?
Sister.
That girl you went out with last year.
I forget. You brought her home once or twice.
The one who works security at the Swedish consulate?
Mala? Yeah, she's head of security, actually. Funny, I thought about her earlier, what with all the Strandberg protests and stuff. What's she doing here?
Hey, good to see you, man. Possible intruder. Sweeping area. Over. Anyone there?
Got one left. I'll go find a spot and then we head back to the school. How's that?
Sure, we'll wait. Jeez, what does General Zaden want? Paper the whole city with these things?
Yeah, you know what they say. The bigger the lie, the more people will believe it.
Yeah, I don't know. What if the real Crystal Dawn finds out? They won't look too kindly on us creating revolutions in their name. Fraud. They're terrorist organizations. What are they gonna complain to? Look, if they do find out you are on the far bottom of the airport.
Mr. Bramber.
Ah, come closer. I have everything to go.
Yes, yes, step in.
Hello, soldier.
Soldier? Hey, soldier, you can't go through here. You crazy? You need to go back to where you came from.
How's your father?
Doing well. Thanks for asking. He's upstairs right now working on this novel.
Look alive, soldier. Sorry. You need to leave. Please leave now.
Oh, that's nice. So he doesn't miss the old school.
Well, he was headmaster for 30 years.
Well, maybe now he'll be a famous writer instead.
The old headmaster of the school Zaydan is using as his field HQ lives right above the carpet shop. According to his son, he kept the school's master key out of nostalgia. Supposedly, this opens any lock in the building.
Private?
Hey, printer.
Hey, don't print anything you see here, all right? I told you.
General Zaydan keeps coming down here to check on the prisoner.
hear they were close, so what'd he do, poor bastard?
The way I heard it, his brother was one of the policemen who got killed when the Mercs attacked Strandberg's prison transport this morning. So he got cold feet, tried to blow the lid on the whole operation.
Not smart.
But pretty human.
According to the soldiers, the condemned prisoner in the cell was a close friend of Zaydan. However, when his brother, a Marrakesh police officer, was killed during Strandberg's breakout, the prisoner decided to betray Zaydan and go public. Alas, he was caught before he could thwart the coup d'etat.
Glad I wasn't picked for the firing squad.
I hear you.
Move along, printer.
Hey, print man.
Now to locate General Zaydan.
So what did he do? A prisoner?
Never you mind. General Zaydan says the man's a traitor and that's all there is to it. Probably got cold feet about the operation. Tried to rat us out. Ask the captain. He'll know.
He's been on that phone forever. Wonder what's so important.
Ex-wife. Yeah, I bet that's why you saved the execution for after the phone call. Commanding a firing squad is a pretty good way to vent. Beats screaming into a sofa cushion.
That's pretty cynical. A man's life is on the line.
Wanda? Wanda? Wanda, if you would let me finish, I... Wanda? What can I say? I'm sorry, Wanda. I am. I'm sorry. You know, you can only say it so many times and still... Granted, but... Yes, I... Wanda...
Secretary of State. He got his military training at West Point. Silver spoon.
Please step back.
Still, his brother's a diplomat, and his sister, she's a UN lawyer. Something drew him into the military. I think he's a danger junkie. Someone told me his age was part of a strike like that.
Don't believe everything you hear.
Next thing you know, they'll have him at the grassy knoll.
Wouldn't that be something?
Still on guard duty, huh?
Yep.
Hey, mind if I take a swing at the lousy rat?
Nah, no can do. Only officers are allowed in. Zayden's orders. Don't know. Maybe he thinks treachery is contagious.
Maybe.
That is General Reza Zaidan, Keeper of the Peace.
Lieutenant, status report.
Sir, the troops are all in place. Ready, willing, and able.
Very well. We wait until the looting starts, then we roll out the tanks.
Crowd storms the consulate, and Crystal Dawn takes the plane.
After which, we trigger similar cells in Rabat and Casablanca to create a domino effect. By tomorrow, it should be painfully clear that the government has lost control of the riots. And, as highest-ranking general, I will, with a heavy heart, of course, do the only responsible thing and impose martial law. I should be president by Friday. So, I trust your wife's operation is without complication.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
We take care of our own, Lieutenant. As you were.
What the?
Strange noises here. Looking into it. Over. Nothing here. Turning to post.
Target down. Move on to Klaus Strandberg. So, in case of an emergency, Strandberg and Zaydan will meet face-to-face at the center of the underground tunnel. The conspirators can summon each other over the phone using a set of keywords, one of which is locked away in Reza Zaydan's safe. What if...
Gonna be a ton of paperwork.
Corridor is clear.
Command, area is clear. Please advise. Over.
Back to work, but keep those eyes open.
Roger that. Standing down.
Chest hair, right? Come on. Everyone knows Zayden is just an upper-class bop. His dad was Secretary of State, and his family's practically royalty. The only way this guy was not going to become general was if he took a dump on the flag.
I hear you, brother.
The only way this guy was not going to become general was if he took a dump on the flag.
He got that right.
Sir, stop that now.
Hey, who the hell are you?
Carry on, Private.
You made it. Most impressive, 47. Now to locate Klaus Stramberg.
What's the situation on street level?
Chanting, flag waving, chest beating, the usual stuff. So.
A few stone throwers, but...
The protesters might be all kumbaya now, but they won't stay peaceful for long. General Zayden has seen to that. Once the rioting starts, I want to play the whole function.
Some kind of soldier? Thank you.
possible disturbance in my position. Checking it out.
Someone wants Reza Zayden. Murdered six policemen.
What do we call that being part of the contract?
What? You didn't read page two?
Yeah. Just so you know, when the siege is over, you get a transfer. I hope you and your jet squad will be very happy.
Thanks for responding so quickly. We never expected something like this. We're not Denmark, dude.
Don't mention it. Nobody wants to.
a fellow guard. See you around, man.
Massage expert Connie Engstrom, report at the reception desk. That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
Okay, let's see. What do we have here? Six small screws and five...
It is not fair. It is. It isn't. You can't keep me in here under these circumstances. If I had known... Well, that's easy for you to say. You're not the one supposed to be doing deep tissue massage in a freaking war zone, okay? It is that bad, Donald. It is. Believe me.
Walk me through it. Here
yeah,
he is.
No, do not
so,
put me on hold.
Into assembly. Right. Okay. Naked guy is... What is he doing? Got stomach cramps, or what is he doing? Oh, wait, I get it.
Hey, it's me. Yeah. Yeah, I was just thinking about you. Yeah, I can't wait. So, what are you doing? Nice. What are you wearing? Boy, that's... I like that. Don't you worry. I'll bring Uncle Buzzy. Yeah. I can't wait. Okay, I'll call you later. Bye, baby. Whew. Not my scene tonight, no siree. Hey, you seen Ramon? No?
Probably sleeping in a closet somewhere.
Massage expert Connie Engstrom, report at the reception desk.
Yeah, I saw a whole
that
bunch of them down
Connie
in the car park.
Connie Engstrom,
nothing
please
like
go to the reception desk.
Figures.
Move along. Oh, sorry, you work here, don't you? My bad.
Hey, brother, what's up? Sorry, I'll count.
Just throw a stone already.
You gotta stay
at this thing over with.
We'll
see who gets the last knock. I'll be sipping my ties and we'll be exploring the wonderful world of military rule. So long, suckers.
Three years, nine months, and 27 days.
That's how long. And you know how long.
Massage expert Connie Engstrom reported the reception desk. That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception
Matthias.
Desk.
Lot 96? Excellent. Did anyone follow you? Good. You got all the paintings from the safe room? The Rembrandt and the Pollock. Ah, that's great, Matthias. You can keep the Croyer. I know you always liked it.
Nonsense. A small token of my appreciation. Let's just say you won't have to cry for me. So long, Matthias. Where's my masseur?
Security detail rules, yeah!
Stromberg. Under the circumstances, I don't really give a shit who's supposed to be calling who. Look, I want your word and get the date for once. Travis is over. Well, I want it again. And what about my
massage
money?
Expert Connie Engstrom reported
I
the reception
the
desk.
An hour.
That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
$7 million. You know what? At this point, I almost know. What's going on? What?
The hell was that?
Both targets down. Now head towards an exit.
Buddy. Good day to you, sir.
massage expert. Engstrom, report at the reception desk. That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
Compromised, but I don't understand. There is no sign of forced entry, no alarms, nothing.
One of my people has gone missing in Johannesburg. A key bearer.
I wish I'd been informed. Still, the system demands two keys, and the rest are all accounted for.
Except for your late predecessors.
Cobb? But his plane went down over the Pacific. It was an accident.
Such was the conclusion at the time. Yes. Die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. It seems like a conspiracy. Probably isn't. And yet, the failed coup in Morocco, the ether virus. Someone knows about us. There was a pattern, and I failed to see it. Providence is under attack.
How much was there?
Money? Not money, Mr. Fannin. Information on all of our assets and operatives. Like you. Dig a trench, Director. And make it a deep one. Because none of you are safe anymore.